welcome to another vlog!
So for today's vlog, we'll be testing online recipes. And the online recipe that we will be testing is a recipe for a marble cake. Marble cake, because this has always been my mother's request that I should bake, and this is her favorite. And I have searched throughout the internet for the best marble cake recipe that will fit her taste. The recipe that I've chosen is from YouTube, and she's a Filipino home cook. I think she's from Manila, so I chose her recipe because it's very Filipino, and my mother has a very Filipino taste as well. So let's just see how that cake will turn out, if it's good or not, and I'll give you a review after this one.
Here are the needed ingredients for the marble cake that we'll be making. So first, 4 1/2 cups of flour, 2 cups white sugar, 2 tablespoons baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon salt, and 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract. You'll also need 3 large eggs, 1 cup evaporated milk, 3/4 cup water, 1 cup melted butter, and 1/4 cup of cocoa powder.
Okay, so let's start baking.
Let's start with the dry ingredients. So in the bowl of flour, you'll add the baking soda, the baking powder, and the salt. And you can use a whisk to stir it. Make sure that everything is well incorporated. You can even use a spoon in this part. I just like to use the whisk to make it look like legit. And then if you think it's well incorporated, you can...
We'll set this one aside. And then let's move on to the wet ingredients.
So for the wet ingredients, so in a large bowl, you place the white sugar, the melted butter, okay? You make sure that everything is placed in the large bowl. Then add the evaporated milk and give it a stir. And then add the water and then give it another stir. As you can see, I'm using a spatula here. I really like using spatula, I don't know why. Then add the eggs. Then later on, I'll realize that I think it's better to use whisk in this part. And then there, I'll use a whisk now and give it a good stir. I didn't really mix it that fast. Okay, I will now add the vanilla to the mixture, then whisk it. Make sure that everything's been placed into the mixture so that you can see it really smells good if you could just smell it.
After mixing all the red ingredients, you can now start adding the dry ingredients.
So I will now start adding the flour mixture to the butter mixture. So give it a good whisk. So as you can see, I didn't add all of the flour mixture into the butter mixture. I'll be doing this part gradually. This is to ensure that everything will be incorporated well, and I realized that it's good to use the strainer because there'll be big lumps if you don't use it. It starts to get messy here, so that's a tip, guys. You should use a strainer first. That's my mistake in this part of the recipe. As you can see, the consistency is starting to change. It begins to thicken. Then that's the consistency that you'll need to achieve.
Okay, separate container. We set aside like a half of this mixture. Then we'll add the cocoa powder in order to make the chocolate powder.
So I transferred a part of the batter to a small bowl. Then I'll be adding the cocoa powder. Then give it a whisk. Then, as you can see, it's not good to work on a small bowl, so I transferred the batter to a larger bowl. Then there I began to stir it, and I now have my chocolate batter. So this will go to the chocolate part of the cake. Time to preheat the oven. So let's start placing the batter into the cake pan. So I'm using a springform cake pan. You should be careful when you're using this one, because see, oops, it gets like that. Then after adding the original batter, you put next the chocolate batter in an alternating way, so that when it cooks, you'll see a pattern, the usual pattern that you see in marble cakes. I don't know, I just saw this one from the original recipe that we're following. In your recipe though, the consistency of your batter is more liquidy. Mine is a bit thicker. I don't know why I followed the ingredients and your instructions. Let's just see how this will turn out. So there, the original batter is almost finished. Then I placed the left chocolate batter on top using a spoon. Then I used a toothpick to make swirls. Bake the cake. As you can see, it's really risky to use a kind of cake pan, but yay! See, it just turned out well. The cake really risen. I think that's because of the 2 tablespoons of baking powder. And this is the result that you get. This is the pattern that I was telling you about. And now it's time to taste the cake, and I will tell you how it turned out.
So if you've reached this far, it means that you have finished everything, the steps and making the cake and the outcome. So let's first give it a rating. So if I'll give it a rating, I'll give it a 6.5 for the overall, 6.5 or 7, because first, the texture of the cake is good. It's good. And what else? It looks delicious as well. For the tastes, I think that's the part where I want to improve. It's not that sweet. Maybe it's good for those who are not into that sweet cakes, but for me, I think a little sweeter of the marble cake would be better. And for the chocolate part, I think it's better if a chocolate is added, like, you know, the chocolate or maybe chocolate syrup, just to give it a more chocolatey taste. That's it. I asked my mom. She said the cake is good. She liked it, maybe because she's diabetic and she prefers cakes that are like that. Let's see the opinions of my other sisters that have tasted the cake. So Ina tasted the cake. Let's ask her. Give the cake a rating.
Is in 8 over 10.
Why? Because it's not sweet.
You don't like sweet?
Huh? Not sweet? I give it 6.5. Remember, was that with chocolate? Crazy dog! Okay, MJ, your turn. Come here. Next, it's MJ! So I will be placing down below the link of the recipe of the cake, and you can try it in your own homes and tell me if you liked it. And for the next testing online recipes video, you could comment down below, what recipe should I follow or what should I bake next?